Hi students, welcome to day 6, 9th class English medium statistics. Maybe this is the last class for statistics. Today we are going to discuss the third central tendency, that is mode. Third one, mode. So what is mode? Simply we can identify the observation which is occurring more frequently in the raw data. That data, that observation which is occurring more frequently is called mode of the data. Okay, what is mode? Mode is the value of observation. Mode is the value of observation. Mode is the value of observation which occurs most frequently or you can write like this also, the observation with the maximum frequency is called the mode of the data. So let us see some examples for this. Suppose the given raw data is like this: 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 5, 8, and 5, and 10. So this is the raw data. So we can find the mode of the data just by observing the observations. So you can write the ascending order of the observations, that is 2, 3, 4, 5, once again 5 is here, and once again 5 is here, next 7, 8, and 10. How many observations are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here this is in ascending order. Observe that the 5 repeats more times, isn't it? Therefore, mode of this data is equal to 5. Okay. So let us take one more example for this. Suppose the following numbers are the sizes of shoes. The following numbers are sizes of shoes sold by a shop in a particular day. Find the mode. So here the observations are like this. The observations, that is the sizes, are 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 6, 7, 10, 7, 6, 7, 9, 7, 6. So we have to find the mean of this raw data. So after arranging ascending order, you can find easily the mode of this data. So here observe that the smallest size of the shoes is 6, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4 times, 6, then 6, and 6. And now 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times, 7, 7, 7, 7, and 7. And next 8, only 1 8 is here. And next, the size of the shoe, 9, 1, 2. And next, the last one, 10. So here, the 6, the frequency of 6 is 4, and the frequency of 7 is 5, and 8 is 1, and the frequency of 9 is 2 and 1. Therefore, the observation which occurs more frequently, otherwise the observation with maximum frequency, that is here 7, you can write like this also. Here size of the shoe, size of the shoe, and number of shoes, number of shoes sold. So here size of shoe 6 and 7, 8, 9, 10, these are the sizes. A number of shoes sold is a 4, isn't it? So frequency of 7, this is 5, and 8 only 1 pair, and this is 2 and 10. 10 is 1. The frequency of 10 is 1. Here 7 occurs 5 times, that is the frequency of 7 is 5. Therefore, so this is the mode of the data. Mode is equal to 7. So here this indicates what does this indicate? This indicates the shoes of size 7 is a fast selling item on that particular day. So simply we can find the mode of the raw data by observing also. So here the frequency of 6 is 4 and 7 is 5. This is the maximum frequency. So which size was sold? 7. Therefore, 7, the shoes of size 7 is the mode of this data. That indicates the shoes of size is a fast selling item in that particular day. And now take one more example for this data. Sometimes the data may have only one mode. Sometimes the data may contain two modes. Sometimes the data may not contain a mode. So that is why. So here one note point. Data having only one mode. Only one mode is called unimodal data. Example, suppose here the raw data is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5 and 7. So what is the mode of this data? So here 5 repeats 2 times, therefore 5 is the mode. So here only one mode is here. Therefore, this is this data is unimodal data. You can write like this. So for note number two, if the data having two modes is called bimodal data. Example here, suppose if you take 3, 4, 5, 0, 4, 7, 8 and 9, 10, 5. So here the mode is equal to, here observe that 4 occurs 2 times and here 5 also 2 times. Therefore, 4 and 5. So therefore, this data is called bimodal data. And next one, the data, sometimes the data may not have mode also. The data having no mode. Next one, third note, data having no mode is called no modal data. No modal data. Okay. So here, suppose if you take the first 10 natural numbers, otherwise first 10 natural numbers. Example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the first 10 natural numbers. Can you find the mode of this data? So no number is repeated. That is why. So here the mode of this data is no mode. You cannot find the mode of this data. Why? Because the mode, by the definition, the mode is the observation which occurs more frequently. Otherwise, the observation with more frequency. So that is why. So here this data has no mode. So what is our conclusion? The data may have mode, that may be unimodal, bimodal. And sometimes the data having no mode. Okay. So this is all about the central tendencies of data. The three central tendencies. Now we are going to find the deviation in the values of central tendency. One more important topic. So, deviation. Deviation in values of central tendency. So now let us take one example, that is original data set, and we have to find the mean, mode and median for the data. So here original data set is taking, which are arranged in ascending order, that is the 6, 7, 8, 10, 12, 14, 14, 15, 16 and 20. So this is the original data. Suppose if you want to find the mean of this data and mode of this data and median, these are the three central tendencies. Okay. So now, so what is the mean? So mode, it is very easy to find mode. So here the observation 14 repeats 2 times. Therefore, that is the maximum frequency. So 14 is the mode. How can you find the median? So this is arranged in ascending order only. So therefore you have to count. Otherwise you have to delete pair of numbers from both sides. This is the first pair, second pair and third pair, fourth, and these two remains in the middle. If an average of these two, 12 plus 14, that is 26 by 2, that is 13 is the median, isn't it? And now mean. Mean is the sum of all observations by number of observations. If you add all these things, you will get 122 by 10. 10 observations are here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that is 12.2 is the mean of the data. Okay, this is the original raw data which is arranged in ascending order so that we can find the mode and median very easily. And here mean, sum of all observations by number of observations. Okay, suppose if add 3 to each of these numbers, what happens? Add, the first case, add 3, that is the number 3, to each observation of data, to each observation of the data. That implies you will get 6 plus 3, 9, 7 plus 3, 10, 8 plus 3, 11, 10 plus 3, 13, and 12 plus 3, 15, 14 plus 3, 17, next 17, and 15 plus 3, 18, and 16 plus 3, 19, 20 plus 3, 23, isn't it? So now we have to find the central tendencies for this data. Here you can find mode very easily. Here 17 repeats 2 times, that is the maximum frequency. Therefore here 17 is the mode. And here also 10 observations. We are going to have 2 middlemost observations. So that is 15 and 17. The average of these two is 15 plus 17, that is 32, divided by 2, that is 16. Observe that, is there any relation? By adding 3, I am getting, suppose if the mode of this particular raw data is 14, if we add 3, the mode is also increased by 3. That is 14 plus 3, 17. And here the median is 13 and it is also increased by our adding number 3, that is so that we get 16. So can you find the mean of the data without adding all these and dividing with 10? Yes, we can. That is, so here the mean of this data is 12.2. We are adding 3 to each of the observations so that the mean also raised by 3, so that you can get the mean of this data is 15.2. You can verify that you add all these things, you are going to get 152. Why? Because in each case 3 is added. So here 10 observations are here, 10 into 3, 30. Already here 122 plus 30, that is 152. 152 divided by 10, that is you are going to get the mean of this data also 15.2. Likewise, you can find when an observation, a particular observation is added to each observation of the data, then the mean and mode and median also raised to that value. Okay. And suppose what happens if multiply. So multiply 2 times. multiply 2 times each data value. So then what happens, you are going to get, so here the original data is this one, 6 into 2 12 and next 7 2 ja 14 8 2 ja 16 10 2 ja 20 12 2 ja 24 and 28 15 2 ja 30 16 2 ja 32 and next 40. So here observe that after multiplying this data with 2, you get these values. Can you find the mode of the data? Here 28 repeats 2 times. That is the maximum frequency observation. That's why it's a 28. And now the median, here 10 observations are here. By removing this, you are going to get 2 middlemost values. The average of these 2 gives the median. That is 24 plus 28 by 2. So here you are going to get 24 plus 28, that is 52. So 52 by 2, that is 52 by 2 means 26. So is there any relation between these two? So 14 into, I am multiplying each observation with 2. Therefore, the mode is also 14 into 2, that is 28. And now you can find the median in the same way, 13 into 2, that is 26. Without calculating this, from the original data, if you find the mean, mode and median, you can find the mean, mode, median of the new data which is obtained by multiplying 2 or any other number. If it is multiplied by 2, the mean is also multiplied by 2, and the mode is also multiplied by 2, and the median is also multiplied by 2. So therefore, the mean, what is the mean of the raw data, first data, 12.2 into 2, that is 2 ja 4 and 12, 24.4 is the mean of this data. Suppose if you subtract also, you will have the same result. That is, if you subtract one observation, mean, from mean also you have to subtract the same value. So here you can write a note that if we add the same amount to all data values, mean, mode and median, these three central tendencies all shifted by the same amount, this is the point. So here I am adding 3 to each of the number, therefore the mean is shifted to this 3, 12.2 plus 3, 15.2, 14 plus 3, 17, 13 plus 3, 16. And here one more note, suppose if we multiply, the same amount with all data values, so mean, mode and median, these three central tendencies will also multiplied by same amount. So what operation is doing here, that operation must be done to get the new mean, mode and median. So these two notes are to be remembered. Okay, these are the deviations in values of central tendency. If we add a certain number to each of the observation to the raw data, then we have to add the same number to find the mean. Without calculations, you can find the mean of this data, mode of the data and median of the data. Okay. So now, let us take some questions regarding this chapter. So here is a question for you. Write markwise frequencies, markwise frequencies in the following data. So here marks were given like this, marks and number of students were given. So here marks up to 5 marks, and here up to 6 marks, up to 7 marks, up to 8 marks, and up to 9 marks, and up to 10 marks. So here up to 5 marks, there are 5 students, and here 11, 19, and 31, 40 and 45 students are here. We have to write the markwise frequencies in the following data. So here the answer, how to find the answer for this? The marks are nothing but the xi, isn't it? Marks, the observations. You have to write the frequency fi. You have to write the markwise frequencies. This is the question. So what marks are here? 5 marks. Up to 5 is different from 5, exactly 5, and 6, and 7, 8, and 9, 10 marks. We want to find how many students secured 5 marks, and 6 marks, and 7 marks, exactly we have to find. For this, up to 5, the frequency is 5 only. Up to 6, there are 11 members, isn't it? 11 members means, here this contains the marks obtained less than 6 also. That is why to find the marks secured by 6 students, you have to subtract this from this, 11 minus 5. So that is 6. So marks, 6 marks were got by 6 students. That is the frequency of 6 is 6 here. And now 7 marks. Up to 7, there were 19 members. In this 19, these two numbers were included. That is why this was included. Not these two, this was included. In this number, this was included. That is why 19 minus 11, that is, you are going to get 8 as the frequency of 7. And next, 31 minus 19, that is 12 is the frequency of 8. Next one also, in this way, 40 minus 31, that is 9. And next, 45 minus 40, that is 5 students. So here, this is the frequency. You have to write, this is Actually, the cumulative frequency, isn't it LCF, 5, 11, 19, 31, 40, 45. It is an increasing mode. The less than cumulative frequency is here. That is why you have to write the frequency of the marks. So, and this is one type of question. And now, we are going to have the second question. So, here, for one question, how to find mean, mode and median. So, here number of, second question, number of sweet packets and cost of each packet are given as follows. Find mean, median and mode of the data. So here the cost, so here I am writing in the vertical mode, that is the cost of each packet, that is xi. And next, the frequency, that is the number of packets, number of packs, that is fi. These two are given. So that is cost 25 rupees, 50 rupees, 75 rupees, 100 rupees and 125 rupees and 150 rupees, the cost of each packet. And number of packets taken, that is 20, 36 and 32 and here 29 and 22 and this is 11. Okay, this is the ungrouped frequency distribution is given. For this, we have to find mean, median and mode also. So, for this we have to remember the formulae, that is the mean. You can find mean is sigma fi xi by sigma fi. So, that we have to prepare one more vertical table. For median, we have to find the LCF so that we can find the median for ungrouped data. And for mode also, we can find mode for this data, how to find. Okay, let us see. So, for this, we can write, to find the median, we require LCF, that is less than cumulative frequency. For this first one, 20, 20 plus 36, that is 56, 56 plus 32, 88, 88 plus 29, that is 117, 117 plus 22, 139. And 139 plus 11, that is 150. So, from this you can write this n value is nothing but 150, isn't it? If you add all these things, you will get 150. Okay, right. So, with this you can find the median. And remember this process. And now, to find the mean or that is arithmetic mean, we require sigma fi xi. That is why we have to find fi into xi value also. So, this is also required one to find the mean. So, what is fi into xi? These two values, 25, 20s, that is 25, 2 is 50, that is 500, and 50 into 36, you get 1800. And 75 into 32, you get 2400. And 100 into 29, 2900. 125 into 22, that is 2750, and there is 150 into 11, that is 1650. If you add all these things, you will get 12,000. This is nothing but sigma Fi Xi. So now, the first one, we have to find the mean. So mean X bar is equal to sigma Fi Xi by sigma Fi. Isn't it? That is, what is sigma Fi Xi? 12,000 by 150. Simplify it. This and this cancel. That is 15, 1 ja, 15, 8 ja, 80. You get the 80. And now, number 2. So, we have to find the median. How to find the median? For this, the total number of observations is equal to 150. This is even number, isn't it? Even. So, therefore, n by 2 plus 1th observation is equal to 150 by 2. That is 75th observation is required. And n by 2 plus 1, that is n by 2 is already 75 plus 1, that is 76th observations. So, where does these two observations falls in LCF? So, here LCF is 20, 56 and 88. Yes, in this observation, in this, these two observations, these two falls in LCF of 88. So, therefore, you have to underline in this numbers. So now this observation, you have to select the median from the observation. Therefore, the median of this data is equal to 75. And third one is very easy, mode. How to find the mode? By the definition itself, the more frequency observation. So here, look at the frequency. Here, what is the highest frequency? This is the highest frequency, isn't it? This is the highest frequency. Therefore, you have to write the observation with more frequency is called the mode. Therefore, the mode of the data is equal to, mode is equal to 50. How you are writing the mode? So, here the mode is nothing but the opposite to the highest frequency. Opposite to the greater frequency value. Finish. So, for the one given raw data table, we can find the mean, median and mode in this way. Okay. Now, let us take some more examples which are going to be asked in examination. Some questions like this. Dhanush said that the mean of first 10 natural numbers is 5.5. Do you agree with him? Justify your answer. So this is the question. How to answer this? First of all, you have to write the mean. So mean of, the mean is denoted by X bar. The first 10 natural numbers, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9 plus 10 by 10. If you add all these things, 10, 9 plus 1, 10, 20, 8 plus 2, 10, 7 plus 3, you will get 55 by 10, that is equal to 55.5. Yes, I agree, you have to write like this, with Dhanush, Dhanush. So why? Because the mean of the first 10 natural numbers is 5.5. He said that the mean of first 10 natural numbers is 5.5. Yes. Why? Because these two are same. And in this way, the questions will be asked. And now, one more question. The mean of the prime factors of 24 is A, 2, B, 2.5, C, 4, and D, 7.5. So, question is like this. You have to write the prime factors of 24. So, first write the factors of 24. What are the factors of 24? 1 into 24, 2 into 12, 3 into 8, and 4 into 6. And next 5 table does not come. 6 into 4. So, here you can stop like this. You can write, these are the all the factors. From these factors, you have to look at the 5 factors. This 2 and 3. So therefore, mean is equal to 2 plus 3 by 2, that is equal to 5 by 2, that is equal to 2.5. So you have to select the B as answer, isn't it? So likewise, the questions, you have to read the question properly and then you go through with the formulae. So one more question is here. If the median of the data arranged in ascending order, that is 7, 10, 14, x plus 4, x plus 8, x plus 11, 27 and 30 is 19, then the value of x, then x is equal to A, 13, B, 19, C, 26 and D, 20. So here already the data is in arranged in ascending order, isn't it? How many observations are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 observations. So, this is median, this is not the observation. So, if there were 8 observations, we are going to have 2 observations in the middle. 1, these 2 repeated first pair and second and third, and these 2 are the observations. So, here the average of these 2, that is, so here how many observations? This is the one observation and this is another observation, that is you have to write 2. And here the median is 19, given that you have to solve. So that is x plus x 2x plus 8 plus 4 12 is equal to 19 2 ja 38. So here 2x equal to, that is 26, isn't it? X equal to 26 by 2, 13. So the first answer is correct. So in this way, the applications of the central tendencies are going to given in your examination. That is why you have to learn all these concepts thoroughly. So now, let us take one simple example, one question. The facts are figures. Collected with a definite purpose or A is the question, frequency and B data and C tally marks and D bars. So, by the definition, facts or figures are collected with a definite purpose or nothing but data. This is the data. Simple question. Okay. And here one more question. The mean of five observations is 10. If each observation of the data is increased by 5, then new mean is A 50, B 15, C 5, D no change. As we have discussed previously, the deviations in the central tendencies, if we add a particular number to each of the data, the mean also increased or shifted to that. That is why here the mean of 5 observations is 10. We are adding 5. Therefore, the new mean will be 10 plus 5. That is 15. Isn't it? So, like this, we can do many questions from this chapter. This is a very important chapter for your 10th class also. So, try to concentrate on this chapter. Okay, so this is the last class of your online classes for this statistics. So, see you. Thank you.